Yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life, all your mercies in disguise?
I want you as you are, not as you ought to be. Won't you lay down your guard and come? The shame that grips you now is crippling. It breaks my heart to see you suffering. 'Cause I am for you, I'm not against you. If you want, don't think you need to settle for a substitute when I'm the only love that changes you. And I am for you, I'm not against you. I am for you, I'm not against you. If you want,
Crane Eater. Good morning. So good to be in the house of the Lord again this morning. Listen, if you're a guest, we're honored to have you. No kidding. We're honored to have you. And we're people of love, prayer, and grace, and we sincerely mean that. If you've been attending this church for a while, you know that. That's what's kept me here for all these years. In the past, I don't know how many years I've been here, 14 years or whatever I've been here, it just continues, the love, and it just continues to grow. I mean, I feel more love now than I ever have by people in this church. So I'm just blessed to be here, and I know that this is a place where God moves, and I want to be a part of it. So if you're a guest, we're honored to have you worshiping with us today. If it's your first time, you haven't filled out a Connect card in the seat backs, please do that. Give that to a member of guest services outside in the foyer, and we have a token of appreciation for you being here today. So before we start, let's open with a word of prayer. Dear God, Heavenly Father, we love you. We appreciate everything you've done for us. Please help us to be in the moment, dear God, to not miss anything you have in store for us, to always be mindful and grateful of all the blessings that you've bestowed upon us here in this church and in our lives, dear God. We pray that everything spoken in this house today will reflect the love of God, because we know you love us, and you proved it by sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to this earth to die for our sins. We are humbled, knowing that without you, we have no direction. We have no purpose. But in you, we have direction and we have purpose. Help this church to reach out to people in this community for this 2024 outreach that we're taking part in. Dear God, that it will flourish and it will sustain from now on, as long as this church exists, dear God. Help us to be razor sharp in our focus in all things that we do and say in this community and outside these four walls. In this Jesus' name we pray in. Amen. Amen. So the first announcement. This is the last week before Barbecue Boogie and Blues. You can still give on Realm under the evangelistic outreach or donate with cash or check and the tithe envelope and just donate it, denote it for the barbecue outreach. If you would like to help in evangelism in the tent, see Anthony Jeffords. So it's this Friday, the 26th, 6 to 10, and Saturday, the 27th, from 10 to 10. So come out, support, volunteer, eat some barbecue. In the foyer, there's some T-shirts for sale, $10. The barbecue team name is Holy Smokes, so that's a pretty good name. Should be a great event with plenty of opportunity to ask people, who do you say Jesus is? So we're appreciative of... Serving the samples, okay, he just... Sandwiches, serving the sandwiches. Okay, if you've had any experience in making a sandwich before, okay, your expertise is needed. Some of you guys went to college for that, I'm sure. Maybe took a training course on, maybe you worked at Subway, I don't know. So, yes, just this opportunity is just for you. So, you know, we are looking forward to this weekend. It's going to be a great weekend, and it's going to be one of those times that, if we are who we say we are, you know, it's the rubber meets the road, and it's time to take action. We're doing these things. The next announcement I have, a couple different things this week. The library is open immediately after service next Sunday, April the 28th. And the 55 Club, you're going to meet next Sunday at 6 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall. Yay, we got one yay here. Anybody else excited about that? Okay, yep, we're excited about it, okay. So you guys always have a good time. We know that. And God is right in the middle of it. So it's always a good time with the 55 Club, I'm sure. Okay, so opportunities to serve. Now, look, one of my pet peeves, I just got to be honest with you. Can I be honest? Or you want me? You don't want me to sit up here and tell lies, do you? No, absolutely not. But, you know, when I'm at a place and somebody introduces somebody and says they're an active member of so-and-so church, an active, you know, they read out this little bio, and so-and-so is an active member of this church. Well, I sort of scratch my head and say, you know what? Is there any other kind of member of the church? I mean, if you're not an active member of the church, if you don't say active, you know, and you just say, I'm a member of Crane Inter Community Church. I mean, you shouldn't have to say I'm an active member, right? You shouldn't have to say that. So when somebody says I'm an active member of the church, I'm probably assuming you're not. I'm just saying. I'm being honest, right? I'm just, that's where my brain goes. I don't know. Somebody said, oh, you're being... I'm not trying to judge you. I'm just saying, like, if we're a member of Crane Inter Community Church and there's opportunities all around us to serve, let's do it. Jump in and do it. If somebody hadn't come to ask you personally and, you know, reached out and looked you directly in the eye and say, will you do this? We're sorry we hadn't, but it's time for you to seek out those opportunities, and we're announcing it. Do it. You'll never feel better in your life than when you start to serve God and you start to pour your life into other people. You'll never feel better. Maybe you're in a place right now where you're a little down, you're a little out, but I promise you, if you focus your eyes on the prize, and that is our eternal life with Jesus Christ and God in heaven, okay? And you pour yourself into other people and show them the love of Christ, I promise you, your heart will never, never feel as good. I promise you that. Here's an opportunity to serve. Teacher Appreciation Day at Redbud Elementary School, May the 8th at 10 a.m. Please see Sister Kelly Messer, wherever Kelly is, where's she at? She's right here. She's right here with the flute up there. See Kelly Messer. There's a sign-up sheet. It's just, look, we want to pour into our local school system here, our local school. Redbud School is right down the road. I can throw a rock and almost, well, I can throw a rock about 10 times and almost hit the school. No, long more than that. I had a pretty good arm back in the day, but not so much now. I don't think I could do it. I could hit a golf ball about 50 times and maybe hit Redbud School. But anyway, it's just right down the street. So it's a place where we want to be in the community. Well, this is our community. So if you can do that, if you're retired maybe, or you got the day off of work on May 8th at 10 a.m., see Sister Kelly, and she will hook you up with an opportunity to serve in this community. So I'm going to turn it over to Sister Nina. She's got a couple things she wants to announce real quick.
Good morning, church. Aren't we glad? This is a great day to serve the Lord. How great is our God? Praise Him. Yes, He is great. Well, I have two things I wanted to announce, and I'm really excited about these. Neither one are really, really new. But we have Growth Track coming up on May 5th. And if you are sitting here and you have been coming and feeling the Spirit of the Lord, and you want to know more about the church, and you want to possibly connect with us, listen, that's what we're about. We're about welcoming you into this body of Christ. And so that's what we want to do with Growth Track. It is 4 Sundays. It's during the Sunday school hour. It starts at 10 o'clock in the morning. And we have it right here in what we call the green room on this west hallway, the west wing. And we do that at 10 o'clock in the morning on Sundays. It's for 4 Sundays. We'd love to have you come and be a part of that. When we first started this class 10 years ago, we called it something a little different. We called it Crane Eater and You, but we tweaked it a little. But said all that to say this, I used to write out handwritten invitations, and people loved it. And I'm so sorry that I'm not able to do a lot of that right now, but I want to tell you, I'm personally inviting you to come and be a part of this class, because we want you to be a part of us. And we want to tell you a little bit about ourselves, what we believe, and we want to know a little bit about you and get to know you a little bit better. So that starts May 5th at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, and that's right here in this green room. So you are personally invited. Okay. All right. The second thing I wanted to announce to you is we have a great opportunity, and that is for our young people to go to Legacy Camp. Dr. Michael Knight is a pastor of a large church in Kentucky, and for many years he has done much research in the field of retaining youth in the church. And I want to tell you, I've come to love this man's writings and what he has done, the research he has done. And he lists out 10 things that have to occur for children to see the worth, young people, young adults, to see the worth in what we are doing for God. And one of the things is that they have to have an invitation, and they have to have an opportunity. Now, you are the invitation. You are the one who walks with Jesus and shows them the way. You're the one who tells them about the glorious God that we serve. And you're the one who makes sure that they have the opportunities to encounter Jesus. Because it is with the encounter of Jesus that we all understand who we're looking for and who we are. And so Camp Legacy is one of those ways that young people encounter Jesus. Another way is in the altar. That's a big encounter with God. And so at Camp Legacy, we do find that kids go there. They have a lot of fun. It's not a second-rate camp. It is a five-star camp. It's a wonderful camp. And so they will enjoy it, and we want them to go and have lots and lots of fun, make good friends, but we want them to encounter Jesus. And that is one thing that does happen at this camp. Our young people encounter Jesus in the altars and with the great teachers and the great pastors that go there and offer up and invest into these young people what they have and what they know about the Lord. High school will go on June 10th through the 14th, and middle school will go June 17th through the 21st. Now, I have myself and another lady who is willing to go and work with the girls. If we have enough for the girls, which we do between the two of us, but if I have extra people who want to go and spend the week with the girls there, then I'm going to go as a camp nurse, okay? But I'm going to be there with the children. Also, we're going to have great people investing in the children. For our boys, we want our boys to be able to go also. Now, we need some leaders, some men who are willing from this church, who have a heart for our young boys to go and be with them, to be their camp leader there at the camp, and to invest in these boys. But I want to tell you, if you've never been to Camp Legacy, you need to go. Sometime you need to take an opportunity to go and see the camp. But I did want to let you know about these opportunities for our young people to encounter God. Praise the Lord. Y'all have a great day. I'm expecting God.
Sorry. She's going to take that mic with her. Amen. Amen. Great announcements, each one. I thought about Donnie and his golf analogy. I would never get to Redbud because hitting a golf ball, all I do is slice, and that just takes you in circles. Amen. I need James and Judy Beneker to come to the stage, please. Where is my brother and sister James and Judy Beneker? Y'all all know James and Judy Beneker. Amen. Yeah. Come on up here on the stage with me. Don't be afraid. I'm not going to bite. Don't they look great? All color coordinated and everything. They do look great. Big smiles. Y'all come over here. Turn and face the congregation. Wow. Y'all are so cute. Brother James and Judy have decided to step down as our guest services directors. Amen. He have done a wonderful job, a stellar job, for almost 5 years, transforming it. Amen. Yes, 5 years. Dedicated leadership. Amen. Always on the top of the everything they're doing out there, come up with some great ideas in our guest services. And they've decided to change hats, do some other things, do some different things in leadership. And we thank you for that. That they're still going to be here. They're not going anywhere. So this is not, we're not anointing them to go forth into the harvest or anything, but we are honoring them today. Pastor, if you would, we gave them a little gift of our appreciation for 5 years of faithful service as our guest services directors. Amen. Amen. So, to fill that vacancy, we have had some people, as difficult as it is to do a follow-up with them, but we have some folks that are very capable of doing that, and we are praising the Lord for some new leaders stepping up in Crane Eater to take on some responsibility, Sister Becky and Jerry Redd. Amen. Sister Becky and Jerry Red. I'm not going to ask them to say anything today. They just look so cute, don't they, and everything. But we do want to pray for them as they endeavor on this new adventure with us. And I'm so excited about what they're bringing to the table. And both of them are just have a love for the Lord, and they're really wanting to get involved. And I tried to get them to be Sunday school teachers first, Sister Nina, but that didn't go. So with that, Pastor, come over and let's pray for them as they go forth today in this new endeavor. Everyone, let's pray. And the church said, amen. Thank y'all. God bless you. We love y'all. Amen. Sister Donna.
There we go. Would you stand for the reading of God's word? I got a pretty loud voice. You know, in the word of God, there are things called a Christophany, where Jesus is referred to. It's a type of Christ. And so our song set begins today describing this scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and 4. And they all drank the same spiritual drink. If you read this whole beginning of this chapter, it's the Apostle Paul discussing the children of Israel. For they all drank from the spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Jesus Christ. So today we want to honor the Lord Jesus Christ. You're hearing us talk a lot about, Paul and I are working on memorizing the Romans Road, so we're prepared to quote these scriptures to those we can encounter for the gospel of Jesus Christ. We want the world to know, not to brand Crane Eater in any way, but that we are seeking to help the Lord win the lost. We can't save them, but we can reach out to them. So our heart's desire is to see you become a child of God today. Today is a day of salvation, and will you worship, Lord, let the Spirit of the living God engulf this house. Lord, let every worshiper not present anything that's blind or dumb or lame. No, God, we want to give you our best worship today. You are worthy, and you are worthy alone. In Jesus' name, amen.
There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need, you got. There's honey in the rock.
Where the Spirit is,
bow
me in the wilderness. You will always satisfy. Honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need, you got. It's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hand. Started flowing when you said it is done. Everything you did's enough. I keep looking, I keep finding, I keep giving, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need.
keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep proving.
I have all that I need. You are all that I need.
I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, keep providing. Moving, I keep praising, you keep proving.
I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I have all that I need. You are all that I need.
Honey in the rock,
water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go.
I don't need to worry now that I know.
Everything you need, you got, is honey in the rock.
Purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hand.
Started flowing when you said it, it's done.
Jesus, who you are is enough.
It's honey in the rock.
It's honey in the rock.
It's honey in the rock.
Honey in the rock.
Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus.
Freed my soul, and for the first time I had hope.
feel him, church? Oh, we thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for touching us.
I'm living proof,
oh, yes, we are,
of what the mercy of God can do.
Thank you for your mercy.
'Cause if you knew me then, you'd believe me now. He turned my whole life upside down, took the old,
oh, yes,
and he made it new. That's just what the mercy of God can do. Now I'm alive to tell the story, how I've overcome. Is His goodness and mercy and the power of His blood. I'm so glad that my freedom wasn't based on what I, but the goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. Oh, there's mercy in His blood. Oh,
yes.
Oh, here's my testimony. I thought I deserved to be 6 feet deep. Choices made that I regret. Oh, I would still be lost. Oh, and there's another part of the story. Oh, but for the mercy of my God.
Now I'm alive to tell the story, how I've overcome. It's His goodness and mercy and the power of the blood of Jesus.
example, Lord. You're the living proof of our example. You're an example. You're our living proof. You are our example. Spirit of God, have your way. Spirit of God, have your way. We welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Angela's got something.
Thank you, Jesus. It is by my great mercies that you are not consumed. It is by my great blood that you are upheld. It is by my hand that I love you and I gave all for you. And you are called to me and you are mine. And I go before you in love and in mercy. And I draw you to myself. For you are mine, says the Lord.
Woo. Let's give the Lord praise. Come on. He has spoken to us, Lord. Thank you so much, God. Thank you for the words of prophecy, Lord. We don't despise prophecy, Lord. We thank you and we admonish you for it, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Sister Angela has something that she wanted to share.
And therein lies my testimony of what the Holy Spirit just gave us, that we are His because He has called us to be His. The one who knows us more than anyone else, the one who knows our shortcomings as well as our talents, and yet He says, I love you. And He doesn't just say, I love you, but He has shown that He loves us because He's died on the cross and the blood that we sang about. And see, when we sing up here, we've already had church before you all got here, because you can't sing the words to this song without a great admiration for a Savior who has given His life for us.
Amen.
You can't sing this song and know that nothing else matters. No matter what we're going through, there's purpose in His plan. That first song says there's purpose in His plan. And because we can know that we are His, because we can depend on that we are His, we can have trust that He has our destiny, as we learned and was reminded yesterday at the women's conference. His destiny can be our destiny when we just choose to walk with Him.
Amen.
When we choose to walk with Him. So today, in this moment, if we're going to have the heart of worship, we talked about in Sunday school that the words of our mouth proclaim the goodness of God. Yes. That our actions show forth the goodness of God when we reach out to a lost and dying world. That our actions show forth the faith of God when we believe for our brothers and our sisters.
Hallelujah.
To walk circumspectly before the Lord. How is that? To walk faithfully, to be mindful of His goodness. I'm thankful. So someone here today, the Holy Spirit, God the Father, and His Son wants you to know He's calling you. He's calling you to walk closely with Him. He's calling you to lay aside everything, every moment of doubt, of self-doubt, of doubt of what He can do through you, of doubt that His grace is sufficient for even you, that His mercy is powerful enough for even you. So the challenge today is, are you going to accept that? Are you going to understand that it's only His mercy for all of us? There's none of us that are good enough. There's none of us that are worthy enough for His mercy and His grace. We're all just recipients of the blood of the Lamb. And Lord, praise you.
Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord, for meeting us here. Thank you, Lord. I know in the past that I've talked to some of you that have written to, you can be seated if you like, written some in our prison system. And I thank God for that. I don't know how lively we are of that, but a good example of that is Preston Davis is here, and he's out, and he's free, and we thank the Lord for that. We pray in the name of Jesus that Preston's mind would be free, that he would not hold anything to anyone, that he would look to you, Lord, for his help. You said that we could call upon you and our help, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. I just want to share my heart. I had two hot messages that I've been praying about, working on all week. And then Pastor Paul teaches, and the whole message changed. The Lord is so good, though. I love it when he gives me a word right from the glory, right from the spout. I just want to remind you that Jesus is our example. He's our example. He didn't try to come with wordology that would be 16-cylinder and no one understand, but he gave profound truth, but because him and the Father were one, and he had a mission, and that was to touch humanity, because all of us need a touch from the Lord. When I was a young boy, I can remember being in a round pen in Hartwell, preaching to my horses. I can remember even earlier when Dr. Martin Luther King died, I remember going down the road preaching. The Lord reminded me of those times and how precious these thought times are. I can remember starting off at Towles Chapel almost 35 years ago, and I had not a clue what I was going to preach one morning. And I was so troubled, Brother Paul. You felt that, Anthony. All you ministers know what I'm talking about. I was so troubled. And I got up, and I said, I feel like singing. And I don't know what it was, but Jenny, my wife, my precious wife, the Lord had given her that song. Sweet Holy Spirit, amen. Sweet heavenly dove, come, stay right with us, filling us with your love, filling us with his love, a love that created everything. It was one of those examples, one of those ministry moments in my life, a pivotal time in my life that there were seven people I was preaching to, but it meant everything to me to have a word from God for them. And it's got to be that precious to us now. Yes, amen. I can remember rooming with an American Indian. I don't know his name, but he got down on the bed. And he started praying and seeking the face of the Lord for a good hour. We got up from there. He got up from there. I was watching. I was newly married. I followed him to the Wendy's. We went back to school. Everybody in that Wendy's was like a magnet to him. They came to him. The Lord was using him, anointing him. People were getting saved right there. We got back to the room that night, and I can remember him praying again. Man, it was just doing a work on my heart. And I'll never forget, I told him, I said, I want what you got, brother. I want it. I'll never forget what he told me. He said, you can have it. He said, you can have it, Howard. If you want it, you can have it. That American Indian, myself, wow, God did a 180 in my life. Just really messed up and angry and had a lot of resentfulness in my heart. And just a lot of stuff going on. And the Lord saved me out of that when I really met my wife. She brought Pentecost in my life. I was a Hartwell First Baptist boy, lost as a goose. My fruit was I was lost. And the Lord did an about face in my life. I can remember my pastor when I started attending the Cartersville Church of God, Joe Edwards. He's going to be with us for homecoming. We're going to be talking to him about maybe having Dr. Rutland come sometime. Powerful man of God. He was the president of ORU for several years. God's really anointed him. But during those staff meetings for 2 years at 8 a.m. till 12, and then we always went to Quality Inn, wherever Brother Edwards would take us, and we'd eat the buffet. And I'll never forget those times. It would come to me, and I felt so inferior in that place. I would just, and it would come to me, Pastor Howard, Howard, what do you have to say? I would hardly have nothing to say. It was in me, but I just couldn't get it out. Kind of that way now. We took a singles ministry, and for about 2 years, 2.5 years, it grew from just 3 to about 37. And it was fruitful. It was a wonderful time. And all that time, I was growing. Jenny was growing. We were growing together. I got to be the minister of evangelism for, you know, a 1,000-member church. And I hit the Atlanta hospitals every day and did that for 2 years. I think I made $250 a week, but we were happy as a lark, weren't we? Happy as a lark. I can remember taking Brother Edwards, Pastor Joe Edwards, my pastor, he took me to where I was going to be assigned, down Towles Chapel Road. And he said, Howard, that's how he speaks, Howard, I remember when me and Pansy took our first church. It was like wagon train, curvy roads. He said, don't ever forget this. Simple things in your life that it's going to be memorable to you one year, one day, church. When you're faithful, if you'll stay faithful. As you stay faithful, you'll see that. Thousands of messages. Weekly salvations, miracles, restoration. I'm going somewhere. Pastor, I'm not admonishing me. I'm admonishing, you don't know who I am. How wretched I would be without Jesus, okay? All of us. Pastor Towles Chapel / Global Harvest for 12 years. The Lord's hand, we saw the Lord's hand when we moved from Towles Chapel to Global Harvest, the same church, moved locations, saw the Lord's hand going into the harvest field, into the grain, and pulling it out. It was a wonderful time of growth. We went from there to Gainesville Church of God for 3 years. It was a good time of love for our family. It was a hard church. That's why I was there for 3 years. Very difficult. Great, some great people, great people, Lord. Another example. And I tell you, the greatest example is Crane Eater Community Church. Amen. In my life. These last 20 years have been the greatest years of my life, been the hardest years in our family. But it's been great, rock solid, and God sees that. He sees you. He sees us. We're not in this thing alone. We're going to go back and we're going to reminisce. When you get 62, you can do it. And you're going to reminisce about what God has done. We came in the crane eater, this group of people. Wow. We had very little as far as anything like this. The Rock Church. But Jenny and I came in there after 3 years of where we were. And we saw a group of people that wanted to grow. They wanted the things of God. I can remember straightening up the vision chart that we had in there. Amen. Things that you remember. I remember having communion and having a time that the Lord just anointed me to speak into families' lives, and I want to do that more. That's what a pastor longs to do. To really speak into your life. There's a lot of people that might say they want you to speak into their life, but maybe not. But I've not seen that at Crane Eater. I've not seen that among my friends and family here, because you're my family and my friends. What I've seen here is a group of people that want more. And we're going to step into eternity wanting more. And He's going to be more than enough. He's going to be more than enough when we get into eternity. It's going to be a grand thing. And I'm going to be with my friends here at Crane Eater. This is my home. This is your home. Hallelujah. I'm sorry. I want to share with you John 15. I'm just going to read it from the message. I want you to hear it. I am the real vine. And my Father is the farmer. He cuts off every branch of me that doesn't bear grapes. He knows what He's doing in our life, church. He doesn't cut you off. He cuts off the wild things. And every branch that is grape bearing, He prunes back so that it will bear even more. This is Jesus' words in John 15. You are already pruned back by the message I have spoken. Jesus says, live in me. Make your home in me. Just as I do in you. In the same way that a branch can't bear grapes by itself, but only by being joined, listen to this, to the vine. We can't do this on our own. We have to have each other. We can't be an island. It just doesn't work. It won't work. But when we are part of the vineyard, when we're part of the vine, Jesus said, I'm the true vine. And my Father, He's the gardener. He's taking care of the vine. There's one thing I know how to do is make sod grass look good. I use 10-10-10, and it will help God out a lot. He loves that stuff, and I sure do love it too. I don't like the way it's gone up in price, but it's good stuff. And He told us, He said, I'll be the gardener. I'll take care of you. I fertilize you. I water you. I'll anoint you. I'll give you everything you need. Trust me. The Lord says, trust me. Trust me. You don't want to ever be severed from the vine. There's no intention in us in that, is there? We want to stay connected to the vine. That's why we're having events and doing things. It's not to pat us on the back, but to win one more soul, to touch one more person for eternity. If someone goes to heaven because of what we do. Some of you know Janice Forrest. I have to tell her I preached about her. Jesus, sweet lady, sweet lady. She told me last week, she gives swim instructions. Spirit-filled woman. She said, Howard, if I can save one boy or girl from drowning, I mean, it's just part of her. Jesus is part of you. He's part of us. Sometimes we get in this thing that we can't receive or we're not sure, but I'm telling you that the Lord is part of us. He's with us. He loves us so much. Listen to this. Anyone who separates from me is dead wood. Wow. Gathered up and thrown on the bonfire. But if you make yourself at home with me and my words are at home in you, you can be sure, this is Jesus, you can be sure that whatever you ask will be listened to and acted upon. This is how my Father shows who he is. When you produce grapes, when you produce grapes, when you mature as my disciples, I've loved you the way my Father has loved me. Make yourself at home in my love, in the love of Jesus. Jesus is saying, make yourself at home in the love of Jesus. Receive, make yourself at home. Come on, church, make yourself at home. Hallelujah. We're in the company and the witnesses of angels. We're in the company and the witnesses of the Trinity. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit is here. The power of God is here. I believe without reservation. Ooh, hallelujah. I don't know what you need from the Lord, but he wants to give it to you. I said he wants to give it to you. Hallelujah. I've loved you the way my Father has loved me. Make yourself at home in my love. If you keep my commands, you'll remain intimately at home in my love. He's telling us. If we keep his commands, love God with all our heart and love others, love our neighbor. Who's our neighbor? Everybody's your neighbor as yourself. That's the commands. That's powerful. Man, can you imagine if we all just really, really concentrate and really falling in love with Jesus and giving him some of the grace and the love that he's given us? We need to reciprocate sometime and just give it up to him. Give it all up to him. The Lord is so powerful. He is so mighty. He is here today. He is right now. He's in our presence. Whatever the need is in your life, he's here for you. Listen to this. If you keep my commands, you remain intimately at home in my love. That's what I've done. Kept my Father's commands and made myself at home in his love. I've told you these things for a purpose. This is Jesus saying, this is the purpose, that my joy might be your joy. I love that. And your joy wholly mature. It's not a, you know, surface joy. This is my command. Love one another the way I loved you. This is the very best way to love. Listen to Jesus. Put your life on the line for your friends. Put your life on the line for your friend. You are my friends when you do the things I command you. I'm no longer calling you servants, because servants don't understand what their master is thinking and planning. No, I've named you friends because I've let you in. Listen to this. On everything I've heard from the Father. That's the word of God that we have. It's a life word. Eating it and ruminating on it, chewing it, regurgitating, eating it more, wanting more of Him. And when you get that heart and that desire, when Jesus is really your example, you'll be more satisfied. You'll have a peace. Do I fit in everywhere? I sure don't. I sure don't fit in everywhere. But if it's a spiritual gathering, if it's something holy, I fit right in. I've learned that I fit right in. So I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of the wicked. Give the Lord praise. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Will you stand to your feet? Let's love. Let's understand. Church, I'm telling you, Crane Eater Community Church is not just a community church, but we are making a difference over the world. Our church preach here. I can't wait. I'll tell you what he thinks of me in closing. When I'm around and he comes into a room, he says, "Hey, saints of God." And then he says, "Hey, Howard." I'm going to get him for that. Father, thank you for your love. Thank you that we can abide in your vine. That we're doing it for a purpose that's larger than us, Lord. We want your glory. We want your spirit, God. I want you to cleanse me and cleanse us, Lord. Forgive us of all of our sins and all of our transgressions, Lord. We give it to you right now, God. God, the things that we cannot control, people that we cannot control, we give it to you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
We lay everything at your feet, Lord. We give it to you. And Lord, I am so grateful for this example. Crane Eater Community Church.
Hallelujah.
I am so grateful.
Hallelujah.
To be a part of this example of Crane Eater. I am so grateful. So grateful. So grateful. Thank you, Lord. Will you just thank him with me in your own way? As Pastor Donna leads us in the worship. Lord, we thank you and praise you. Whatever you need this morning, church, I'm telling you that you can have it. That you can receive it right here. You can receive it right where you're at. But if you want some helper, somebody to be a helper of your joy, and that's what Paul said, I can't have dominion of your faith, but I can be a helper of your joy. If you want some helpers of your joy, come right now. Just come right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Need some.
my sins away. Oh, now I'm living like I'm forgiven. You came and set me free. That's what your mercy did for me.
You gave me beauty.
Oh, yes.
My guilty stain. And now I'm living day to day by your grace. So excuse me if I can't contain my praise. I know that I've been saved.
Lord, you found me, you healed me, you called me from the grave. Gave me a real love, I thank you, Jesus. Wash my sins away. Oh, now I'm living like I'm forgiven. You came and set me free. That's what your mercy did for me. Every morning, mercy.
Assignment, Lord. I'm not going to be selfish any longer. I'm going to accept your assignment and see where you take me, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. The church said, amen, amen. Let's love each other, fellowship. Let's thank the Lord for our praise and team and our musicians and audio and video. Thank you, Lord, for them. Bless them, God. Bless them.